Good morning, everyone. Decided today I'm going to keep it quarantine real. I woke up with this wonderful mohawk, and I thought I would just keep it this morning. So thank you for being here. Welcome, Lowell. Welcome, Dave. Glad you could be a part of it. Good morning, Laura. Thank you. Yeah, I'm learning as I go. I've been getting good feedback, so I decided to give a little more lead. A little more entry time for people to get logged in, because it doesn't just show up magically, I guess, is what I understood. So glad you could be here this morning. Hey, Mr. Palmquist, all the way from Kansas, tuning in. Well, I want to welcome all of you. And if you're here watching this morning, put up good morning in the comments. When I use my computer, it doesn't tell me who's there watching, but I'd love to know that you're here participating in today's Mohawk Morning Daily Devotion. This morning, our devotion is going to focus on a piece of a letter, 1 Peter, the first chapter. We'll read verses 3-9 this morning. But before we dive into our devotion, I want to first begin with a word of prayer. Holy and gracious God, we ask that your Spirit would be with us this morning, that it would renew hope in us, restore faith in us, to believe and to trust in your presence, to believe and to trust in your promise made to us in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Guide us this day and every day. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, good morning, Judy. Good morning. Good morning, all. Once again, welcome to everyone. I'm curious to see if anyone remembers this. I remember this show. I think it must have been in the mid 80s, so I was a younger kid. But there was a show called Ripley's Believe It or Not. And if you have ever seen that show or you're familiar with that show, you can show me that by clicking the like button, the heart button, to just show me that you've experienced it. But the premise of that show, right, was that the sense that you had to see something to believe it, because the story was just so unbelievable that if you didn't see it, there's no way you would ever believe it. But you know, that got me thinking this morning, that idea of believe it or not, and seeing to believe. And I wonder, well, what if you can't? What if you don't get the opportunity? How then are you going to believe? And so this morning, before we get to the reading, I want you to think about this, and I want you to reflect on this. I want you to think about the one, two, three people in your life and that you trust so deeply that you would believe whatever they share with you, you know, without a doubt, without question. You know, like if they saw something amazing, told you about it, that even if you didn't see it, you would believe it. And so as I share this story this morning, I want you to think about who those people are, that one person, the two people, the three people in your life that you trust that deeply. So I'm going to grab my Bible. And like I said, I'm going to read 1 Peter. It's in the first chapter, verses 3-9 with you all this morning. Blessed be God. Well, by God's great mercy, God has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead and into an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who are being protected by the power of God through faith for salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you rejoice, even if now for a little while you have had to suffer various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, being more precious than gold, that though perishable is tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed. Although you have not seen him, you love him. Even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and rejoice with indescribable and glorious joy. For you are receiving the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls. Now, the heart of this story we hear this morning is that this first faith community is facing some hardship. And they're suffering from various trials, it says. And so, you know, the author is wanting to urge the people to remain faithful, even though, right, they don't see Jesus. Even though it may not feel like God is present, the author's urging them to continue to believe in who Jesus is and what Jesus has done for them. But like I said, remaining faithful amidst hard times, I think we would all likely agree that's easier said than done. I don't know about you, but I know, you know, for myself that believing, trusting, that somehow, some way, something good will come of whatever the struggle is that I'm facing or working through, whatever the tragedy or horrific event is that I'm witnessing. I mean, having faith in those times, it's not easy. It's not easy to muster up in myself. Which is why, though, you know, I'm glad that it's not on my own shoulders solely. I read this morning and from Peter, and it reminded me of what Luther wrote in the Small Catechism, where he wrote that I believe that I cannot by my own reason or strength believe in Jesus Christ, my Lord, or come to him, but that the Holy Spirit has called me by the gospel, enlightened me with the Spirit's gift, sanctified and kept me in the true faith. And because I think it's important for us to remember that sometimes the faith that we need to trust, to believe, that has to come from the outside, has to come out from outside of us. And so I want to go back to that initial question. And You know, who's that one person, that two or three people in your life that you trust with your whole heart? And when you are struggling, could turn to, so that your own faith, your own trust, your own belief in God's presence can be renewed and restored. Because it's important. Important to have in our lives, because sometimes, you know, we all need someone to give us something to believe in. And so spend today thinking of that one, two, three people who can be your restorers of faith, your renewers of hope. And when you have a need for them, I encourage you, reach out to them. Reach out to them, people you trust with your whole heart, because they will fill you, restore you, and renew you, I promise. Well, I want to thank you all for joining in this morning, for being a part of our Mohawk Morning daily devotion. Tomorrow it probably will be just normal hair, but you know, have a little fun on quarantine. Keep it real. But thanks again for being here, for participating in our daily devotions. Hope the rest of your day goes well. I hope you're staying healthy and safe as you continue to shelter in place amidst this quarantine. I want to close with a word of prayer for us all. Almighty God, in Christ, you bring hope into this world. And through the Spirit, that same hope fills us. Help us, Lord, to find those people in our life who, when we feel we lack faith, that they can restore it in us, renew it in us, and fill us once again with this living hope that you have brought us all into through the life, death, and resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Well, may you be reminded of this day of God's presence, and may you know that the peace of God and the blessings of God are with you now and always. Have a great, great day, everyone.